I've been saying for some time that Fox News is going to turn against the vaccine. And I think generally the response to that has been, oh, come on. Like, sure, maybe a little, but they're not gonna do that. I mean, after all, they want the economy to reopen. They want people to be able to move past this thing. Okay, sure. But they got to advocate, like there's so many crazies that want a voice in the media. And we're gonna start with the dipping of the toe in the waters of that with Tucker Carlson, who had this to say on his show last night.
Coronavirus vaccine is finally here. It's arriving in small bottles, but with a glitzy entrance. The coronavirus vaccine has been accompanied by the kind of corporate image campaign you typically associate with higher end consumer products. Imagine the rollout for a Hollywood blockbuster, the new iPhone. That's what it's like. Suddenly, the COVID vaccine is on the morning shows. It's being touted on celebrity Twitter accounts, and the news about it is uniformly glowing. This stuff is just great. A lot of famous people say so. Feel lucky, too, when you finally get the vaccine. That's how a healthcare worker in Juneau, Alaska feels tonight. Lucky. She got the vaccine 2 days ago. The woman had no history of allergies, but within minutes, she developed a severe anaphylactic reaction to it, and then had trouble breathing. She went up in the emergency room overnight. It was all a fantastic experience, according to the doctor who treated her. Quote, during the whole time, she was still enthusiastic that she got the vaccine and the benefits it would give her in the future. What a cheerful patient she must be. We've got to assume she is in any case, because we can't really know. The authorities didn't release her name. All we know is she's a highly satisfied customer, yet another. Have a vaccine and a smile. Just do it. So how are the rest of us supposed to respond to a marketing campaign like this? Well, nervously. Even if you're strongly supportive of vaccines, and we are, even if you recognize how many millions of lives have been saved over the past 50 years by vaccines, and we do, it all seems a bit much. It feels false, because it is. It's too slick. Come on. This is patronizing. Stop with the slogans. Better to treat Americans like adults. Explain the benefits, be honest about the risks, and let the rest of us decide. In this country, we control our own bodies. They're always telling us that. But no, suddenly the rules have changed. On the question of the corona vaccine, our leaders are definitely not pro-choice. Their view is do what you're told and don't complain. No uncomfortable questions.
Okay, there's a lot there. Yeah, no, talk to them like they're adults. Don't patronize them. He's literally using the voice for his audience, which he always uses, which is how you like dress down a naughty puppy. But they're being patronizing. Brett, I'm gonna let you get in. There's a lot that I have to say, but what do you think about that?
So he's saying, hey, this is unprecedented that there would be PR for a medication, for a drug. Have you watched every commercial break during your show? It's all like it is ridiculous. The thing that pays your bills is PR campaigns around medication, whether it's the actual medication itself or, hey, I'm Tom Selleck. Do you have Medicare? Pardon me. I can give you a really awesome, you know, you get everyone Magnum PI and Medicare supplements. Like, it's all BS. Then he advocates for the doxing of someone who received medical care. We don't know her name. Can you please send me her address? If you can't send me her address, can you draw me a picture of her? No, you can't. Why? Because that's wildly, you know, bad and
unethical.
Unethical? Maybe. Mm-hmm. And that's where he like slides the counter arguments. He just, here is the counter argument. He said it. He acknowledged it. It's actually a good counter argument, but I'm gonna say maybe, and then just kick it to the side and go straight toward like, they want, they're saying, no, if you question anything, you're absolutely evil in terms of everyone else. No, he wants credit for coming up with the questions when his job is to provide the answers. Mm-hmm. Like you're TV news guy. There's answers for all that stuff. Like anaphylaxis is treatable. Has it been announced? Absolutely. Anaphylaxis is something that people can go into, and they say, and Fauci has said it on multiple media outlets, like if you have a background of anaphylactic of allergies essentially, then you should be careful. We take that into consideration. We've reported it. It's 95% effective. But it is Munchausen syndrome that he relies on. He just wants to poison everyone's mind just a little bit and make them so that he keeps them dependent on him.
Exactly.
You know that little thing in your mind that you should probably either ask the question about and earnestly seek the answers. No, 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 no. You're special. You're one of us. And they're all elitists that we're smarter than here. Mm-hmm. This guy talks about glitz. The guy is a freaking pleated pant that got struck by lightning and came to life. Like he is,
oh my God,
100% that guy.
He is. And yeah, I agree. He wants, you said, you know, they're supposed to provide information. Well, of course, like, yeah, theoretically a reporter should, but he doesn't want to be the person that just comes out and says the vaccine is bad, don't take it. What he is doing is instead trying to appeal to people who want that message by, in a very cowardly fashion, just raising questions. I don't know. I'm just saying no one will question the vaccine. Well, in theory, during the trials that were done, the scientifically rigorous trials that were done, that's sort of the questioning of the vaccine and the continued watching of people who've taken it and seeing what sort of side effects. That's the questioning of the vaccine. Dunces in the news or your viewers who probably already have a predilection against vaccines and a predilection against taking the virus serious in the first place, that is not the questioning. What he is doing is he is taking anecdotal information about somebody having a negative reaction, which we know exists, except he's not putting it in context. He's not saying 50,000 people were vaccinated yesterday and one had a reaction, because that would be the context we need. He's saying, I'm gonna focus on this one thing that happened. We know that sometimes people have negative reactions. He's being very disingenuous. And the overall thesis is there's a glitzy PR campaign for this thing. He likes that because he can talk out against it and it sounds like he's being a populist. He's speaking out against corporations, these elitists. But his evidence isn't that there's a glitzy commercial campaign. The evidence is that people are enthusiastic, that a celebrity said they want it, that somebody was filmed having it. That's not the corporations, that's a desperate country that's been through a ton, in no small part due to his advocacy for the virus over this year, that desperately wants some good news. And so yes, as people start to get vaccinated, we're gonna wanna see that. And as you know, celebrities are gonna try to encourage people to get it because they want the country to go back to normal too. But he can't actually demonstrate his real thesis. All he has is, look, people are happy that something bad is happening from the point of view of the virus. And he can't have that because again, as we've been saying for a very long time, if at the beginning of the year, the virus had developed sentience and had decided, I'm gonna have a media figure advocate for me all year, I defy you to come up with a way that Tucker Carlson could have done a better job in doing that. Like he seems to be personally bothered by the fact that people are finally becoming immune to this thing, as if the vaccine is controlling his show, controlling his script. The entire thing is just so unrelentingly frustrating. He goes from telling people not to lock down, to not wear masks, to send their kids out, to travel for the holidays, all of that. Don't ask for anything. You shouldn't get any aid. You should expose yourself. And now we finally have the solution that they had been pitching for months as the miracle that'll let everything go back to normal. And he's eagerly speaking out against it, making people question it. The only result of that segment is fewer Tucker Carlson fans getting vaccinated and more people getting sick and more people dying, which is at least consistent with his strategy so far this year.
But this is they're addicted to dopiates. Like they're addicted to Tucker Carlson. They're addicted to this sense of superiority, which is not related to being better. It's related to feeling better. They're gonna go out, they're gonna live their lives. And this is the dose that they take every day at the same time on a very strict regimen to do things that are actually toxic. It is one of the most toxic relationships in all of media, going and watching Tucker Carlson and getting bad advice that's intended to make you feel better, but is wildly destructive to your overall health mentally and now physically. But he's so cute.
No consequences. Like, I know it's bombastic and you're not supposed to say it and I can't prove it and I'll probably get sued and they didn't put through my op-ed for it. But like, does anyone watching this, we can't say who died because of the things he said, but does anyone doubt that those people exist?
No, 100%.
And he makes more money than he did before. He has more control over Fox News than he did before. He spent a year of his career advocating for people to die from a virus. And his life is much better off than it was before that.
Tucker should do man on the street segments where he just goes out and talks to people without a mask. He's never going to do it. He's too smart.
No, he's protected. He's at home. He's at one of his multiple broadcast quality studios at his multiple homes.
Gotta love
it. Richer than he was before. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.